As a game developer, you'll invariably find yourself using a lot of tools. Besides your game engine and IDE, solo developers especially will wind up downloading a multitude of programs for everything from 3D modeling to music to video editing. With each of these softwares, though, comes a decision. Which option should you download? Well, there are many ways to figure this out, but it's important to know all the potential choices. In this video, I'll go through my workflow and describe each software, along with a few personal tips for optimal productivity. I'm not saying that all of these softwares are the best choices, but these are the ones that work for me. All these programs are also free, and most of them are open source. Unfortunately, due to the fact that I'm currently working on a game, I can't immediately switch to Bevy and Neovide, so I'm still using some proprietary software. I'll go over those first, then get to the open source programs, in order from most well-known to most unknown. Unity is the most popular game engine out there, especially among indie developers, so there's not much to say that everybody and their mother hasn't already heard about. It may be slow, clunky, and only free for certain people, but it's certainly powerful and well-documented. That said, these days, I prefer something where I can code a lot of the logic myself, so I'll probably switch to something sleeker after this game. That said, Unity itself can be pretty sleek. One tip that I have is to take some time to learn how to make editor scripts, or even try finding some on GitHub. These are easy to use and can extend the editor functions to save plenty of time. I also made a short video a while ago on how to make simple editor scripts. Visual Studio is the canonical C# editor, and it goes with Unity like peanut butter and, well, more peanut butter. They're really quite similar in style. There's not much to say about Visual Studio, but that's a good thing. Nothing gets in the way from you writing good code. However, similarly to Unity, I have another productivity tip that takes a little effort but saves a lot of time. Try installing the VSVim extension to get Vim bindings for Visual Studio. If you don't know, Vim is a text editor that's probably been around longer than you have. Because of that, it mostly uses the keyboard and allows for fast and accessible navigation after just a little time to learn the keys. You're even able to exit it by just pressing the exit button in Visual Studio. There are plenty of tutorials on YouTube for learning Vim, so I'll leave that to the experts. Let's move on to the open source software, starting with Audacity. This is quite possibly the most well-known open source application out there. You've probably used it already, whether you record sound effects, make devlogs, or even record music. The software is also simple enough to use that I don't have any fancy productivity tips. Here's some advice I learned from Let's Talk Game Design, though. Once you're done editing your audio, speed it all up by 1% or 2%. This just makes you sound a little bit livelier. A tip for me as well, use the truncate silence effect to avoid having to edit out long silences. I don't know how widespread this knowledge is, but I didn't know about it for a while. Blender is, like Audacity, an extremely popular open source program, but not all game devs use it in their workflow. I certainly didn't before Breezy, but now that I do use it often, I'm getting pretty comfortable with it. Since Breezy is a pretty low poly game though, I don't interact with Blender enough to know all the tricks of the trade. I will say this for anyone just starting out with Blender though, if you're importing something into Unity, import it as an FBX file rather than an OBJ file. They seem to be a lot more flexible and easy to work with. GIMP is something I do have a lot more experience in, having made mostly 2D games. It hasn't always been my graphics editor of choice though, I actually started making graphics in Scratch, since I'd used it so much before switching to Unity. Needless to say, GIMP has been much better in every regard. My advice for new GIMP users is to get good at the layer mask system. It's a very flexible tool that can make a lot of different effects much easier. These shadows, layer mask. This dither effect, layer mask. GitHub Desktop is a pretty mundane program. It's not something you interact with on a very deep level, especially as a solo developer. In fact, it may seem like there's not much of a reason to use it when the GitHub for Unity plugin exists. My advice for you though is to ditch GitHub for Unity and just use this software instead. I realized after buying a new computer that Unity actually seemed slower and kept crashing whenever I compiled a script, press play, or even quit the application. I found out after digging through plenty of obscure forum posts that GitHub for Unity was the problem. So if you've thought of abandoning a project because Unity just didn't work, try using GitHub Desktop instead of GitHub for Unity. Shotcut is my video editor of choice. It's simple to use and doesn't crash nearly as often as my prior pick, OpenShot. I haven't used DaVinci Resolve, but they seem to be of a pretty similar quality as far as free software goes. My tip for new Shotcut users is to create filter templates early and often. After I found I was spending a lot of time adjusting music volumes, I just created a filter template for them. These transitions are also a filter template, see? Finally, the most obscure open source software, OpenMPT. I'm surprised that more people haven't heard of this program though, since it's very useful, customizable, and easy. My only gripe with this software is that I wish sound fonts were handled better. With the current state of the program, I have to use the Sforzando plugin to be able to access the instruments properly. And while I don't have a problem with that, it doesn't work with a lot of the effects. I do have a tip for getting around that though. If you want to use effects but you're using Sforzando for sound fonts, add one long note to the beginning of a pattern and render that pattern to a wave. Then switch the render target from file to sample slot. That lets you use your Sforzando rendered instrument as a normal sample. I use this for some of the effects in the Disco Course song for Breezy. So there you have it. My open source workflow for creating Breezy. I'm always looking for new ways to expand my workflow, so if there's a tip that has helped you with any of these programs, or just a software you'd like to shout out, leave it in the comments. Have a good day.